Hey everybody, it's Christine. I'm just gonna take a really quick break from Booktubeathon to do a book haul. They've been piling up for the last couple of weeks, sort of. So my mom and I went to the Friends of the Library bookstore, and outside of the bookstore is a rack that you have free books. They don't charge them; they just want to get rid of them. So I spotted a couple and picks them up. The first one is Black Ice by Michael Connelly. I've heard he's a good author, so it's like murder mystery. So I picked this one up. Then I picked up, and this is I blame Becky from Becky Ford for this. She's got me so interested in Daphne du Maurier that I seen this and picked it up. I couldn't resist. And it's Frenchman's Creek. The no dust jacket or anything. But I've never read anything by Daphne du Maurier, and I figured, well, it's free, I might as well pick it up. So I did. And this one I think was published in, let's see, 1942. So this book is actually 2 years older than my mother. And it's like inscribed. So I picked that up. So, Becky, thank you very much. And then my mom seen this one and she said this was her absolute favorite book when she was growing up. Her mom, I don't know if read it to her or read it and she read it. But it's The Laughing Stranger by Vigna Del Mar, and I'm liking it so a little bit. It's written in 1953, so this is one of my BookTube reads for a book that's older than you. And it's pretty much Civil War, so kind of like if you liked Gone with the Wind. It the protagonist in it is not like Scarlett. She's disabled. She's got a curvature of her spine, so she doesn't think she's ever going to get married. And her brother comes home from the war, the Civil War, and he's not there. So he's dealing with what we now call PTSD. And that's about as far as I've gotten. So, and then I picked this up. I've heard of it and I've seen several different covers of this, but I've seen this one and I just had to have it. I love the cover. You may not know this, but I have two tattoos and one of them is a butterfly with a rose and it's on my ankle because I love butterflies. But it's The Collector by John Knowles. I forget what it's about. I know he collects stuff, but yeah, so I love this cover. I think it's absolutely gorgeous. So I picked that one up. And then we went into the bookstore and I spotted this on the wall and my mom bought it for me. And it is The Girl on the Train by Paula Hawkins. Yeah, I'm a sucker for, it was a dollar. And I didn't have any change on me, and my mom just happened to have it, so she got it for me. And I think everybody knows what this is about. A girl on the train, and she makes up stories about people she sees. And this one couple kind of really intrigues her, and things, and I think the woman disappears. So, anyways, because of the stupid lockout that is not happening right now in Canada Post, my owl crate for June was very delayed. I didn't get it until after the 1st of July. So I luckily was able to switch my mailing address to my American address because I do cross the border all the time. And I have an American mailing address. So luckily the next shipment's going there just in case there's a lockout. But my owl crate for June was My Lady Jane. I still have yet to read it, but it's historical. So I'm looking forward to it. And then I went back to the library because I had some money my husband had given me. And I was hoping to go in there. And for some reason they were closed. They usually open at 10 in the morning and we were there. I was there at 11. For some reason it was closed. Sorry. So again, on the shelf that's outside, for can't talk. The free books. I grabbed three more. And one of them is Lisa Jackson's Hot Blooded. Again, murder mystery. That's pretty, and prostitutes. I'm sold. And then Michael Connelly's Trunk Music. You can't go wrong when they're free. So, I mean, most of my books on my bookshelf came free. People have given them to me. There's a garbage dump on St. Joseph's Island, which is an island that's about half an hour outside of our town. And they have, it's called the New to You boutique sort of deal, where people, instead of throwing stuff out, they give it to them and they sell it. So a lot of my sister-in-law goes there all the time, and she gets me a bunch of books. Not these ones, but they're clean, they're free, except for maybe a donation to keep place running, and it saves stuff from getting put in the landfill. So I get a lot of books from there, whether I want them or not. No, my sister-in-law knows what I like to read, so she'll grab if, when she's there, she grabs them, and we'll probably be going there this weekend because my kids just left for camp, and we'll be going out there, I think, on Friday or Saturday, and we usually make a run there anyway. So, anyways, long tangent. I also picked up Tess of the D'Urbervilles by Thomas Hardy. I've never read this. Not even really sure what it's about, except for Tess. Anyways, so I figured I'd get this book haul done because it was a nice big stack of books. And like I said, I might be going to, it's called the Joss, we call it the Jocelyn Mall. My daughter's there now. So she usually makes a run to the dump every day. So I'll probably be coming home with a whole shitload of books this weekend. Sorry. And I will try and vlog while I'm at camp for Booktubeathon. There's no Wi-Fi out there, so I don't know how well it's going to be, but I don't know if I'm going to be staying out the night because I have to have my sleep machine on, and what we've been slotted to sleep in isn't exactly the best for my back either. So I might just go out for a day and come back in, and then maybe go out for another day, come back in. But it's like an hour drive both like one way. So we'll see. Enough rambling. I will talk to you later. I hope everybody's doing awesome with their Booktubeathon. I'm doing really good. I've already finished two books. Well, I finished four. Two books were from what I was reading on the weekend. Two books were from my TBR. I'm in the process of reading three books right now. I'm doing great. So let me know if how you guys are doing for the Booktubeathon. If you're not doing it, what you're reading. I always like to read the comments. So I hope everybody has an awesome rest of the week. I'll talk to you later. Bye.